The first ones that played, I even remember, and that was two that won, was Tyler Riggin and Kosius, amateurs. The girls, we all had hats made, aprons or some kind of a top. I can remember yellow.
It was a big deal.
Oh, yeah. Big bulletin board. Every team had somebody with them with a sign. I mean, it was really a big deal.
But it's my understanding that there was a Blythefield tournament up in Grand Rapids every summer. And several of the members, the better golfer members, played in it. And one year they were thrown out. So they said, to heck with you, we'll start our own. And that was the start of the Invitational. This is the time to remember, 'cause it will not last forever.
It really started with Kelly Clare bringing in David Jacobson, who was Peter Jacobson's brother, David from Oregon. And he was a good amateur player, and they won. And all of a sudden people started to realize, hey, you know, we're now playing against a whole different level of golfer here. Paul Krylak then got involved. And Paul Krylak owned a lumber yard here in town, and he was a patron of the tournament. And he basically would provide the way for these amateurs to get here and be able to play in the tournament. So he had all kinds of kids coming from Oregon. And if you could find a college where they would send their whole team, he would match them up with somebody. You know, so that was really the beginning.
I think it's always been family-oriented, and of course we have a large family with six children. Two of our boys have played in the Invitational, and one of them has been on the winning team twice, so that's always great fun, and now I get to watch a grandson play in the Invitational.
And I remember my brother John playing in the Invitational a lot. He won it three times, which was always fun, and watching him go around, and as you've heard, I'm sure some of the people who became touring pros were here. I remember Davis Love, watching him play.
It's just a great thing for our club, I think, that tournament, because it brings some interest both from the pro shop and the caddies and membership.
It's been an opportunity for the community to come and see some of the best amateur players, not only in the state of Michigan, but you know, with the Colombians and the Camilo Bejaguses worldwide to come through here and play.
The club has always been conscious of the fact that it does owe things back to the community and wants to pay it back. And therefore, every year for a week, we open up the premises free of charge and invite the public in, not only to walk and enjoy the grounds, but to watch some very good competitive golfers. I refer to them as the flat bellies, the very talented amateur golfers that we invite in to compete during that week.
People come here and they say, well, 6,300 or 6,400 yards, I'll kill the place. More of them leave being killed than kill the place. It's you have to know what you're doing here, and if you don't, you can get in some real trouble.
Bert Cooper, we've played in probably more of these tournaments than anybody else. I don't think poor Bert's ever won it, but he's always had one of the biggest galleries.
He's been obviously in most of the events. He's played in, he's only missed a few, I think. So he is the you know, the heart and soul of the Invitational, and he's at some points during the event kept it going.
My brother I played with, Rick Becker, I played with Dave Llewellyn, played with Bob Skritzky, Oscar Alvarez, David Venegas. So I've had quite a few partners, and you know, some of us have come close, but never in the winner's circle.
you know, he's played in 50-some invitationals here, and I have, in fact, I was born the day he was in the finals. So from that day on, I feel like I've been out here every summer in the Invitational. Many years, my sister Kristen and I would caddy when my dad played with my Uncle Oz.
Well, I tell you, we beat them one up, and I was crying coming off the 18th hole. We beat them. I should be so happy, and I had tears in my eyes when I went over to, because you know the competitive side of you comes out. You don't have a choice. You just you grind and you play, and then I'm walking off the 18th hole, like with tears in my eyes, because I felt like I beat Burt Cooper. I was like, that's not right. There's nothing about it.
Even if he doesn't, the experiences he's had playing in this tournament are unforgettable experiences that will be with him for a lifetime, as they are for me.
Probably with regard to golf, when, you know, the day I beat my dad, that was good. The day I beat Walt Biber was good. And he told everybody in the club about it too, so those were good.
This week we probably got one of the strongest fields we've ever had, so I'm pretty excited about it, and I think it'll be real interesting to see who wins.
A lot of great players coming in. I think there's, what, 18 Division I college players coming in, which is a huge number.
It's a great tournament. It's a lot of fun. I love playing better ball with my partner. It's just so much fun out there. The course allows a lot of birdies, and that makes it fun for the crowd as well. So I always look forward to this week.
I think it's a great place. The course is in great shape, and the place is really good. And here, Mike is a pretty good person.
Looks good. There's some little tricky fun holes out here that I'm sure are going to cause some drama as the week carries away here, but looks like it's in great shape. It's all you can ask for.
So we just drove around and he showed me the course, told me what not to hit it, where not to hit it, and where to hit it, and so we're going to play tomorrow sometime.
What do you think about your partner so far?
Oh, he's a great guy. Yeah, I know we're going to win.
I've played with a lot of guys in college who, you know, hey, have you ever played in the Kalamazoo Country Club Invite? And, you know, it's such a fun event, and, you know, get over there and try playing in it. And, you know, fortunately I was able to do so.
I've always heard that it's a great tournament to come to. Guys always rave about how much fun it is and how competitive it is. And I think for a long time guys came before the Western Am to sort of tune up and, I mean, have a lot of fun in a competitive environment. So, I mean, definitely the word's out there. This is a great event.
There's like a aura around this tournament I can feel already, and that part should be pretty cool about it.
Definitely my biggest crowd that I play in front of all year. So, but it's a lot of fun. They like to watch me play. Not all, like my extended family doesn't get to see me play very much, so this is kind of their opportunity to come out here and watch me. So it's a lot of fun for them and for me to play for them. So it should be nice having them out here this week.
Well, it's 56, so I guess we could say it stood the test of time. It succeeded because of the Kalamazoo Country Club leadership, the Board of Governors and the members allow it to happen, for starters. And then the current administration, so to speak, AJ and Jamie and Craig and Shafty and everybody that pitches in, attracts the college players that we're able to get right before the Western Amateur. So combination of good golf and good golf course.